This is the OTB Television Network, a service of Capital District Off-Track Betting.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's edition of Horses and Courses. 19 races to bring you, including 8 from Gulfstream Park on Saturday afternoon, where they had a couple of starts and stops of rain showers. We're going to kick it off. It was race 5 of the 14 race card, the Skipaway Stakes over a sloppy sealed racetrack.
They're off in the Skipaway. Longshot Ender's Cat goes out to the lead. Valid is right up and on the pace. He's in front, came out running in third right behind them. Then Savoy Stomp on the outside, Team Colors along the rail, and Rich Daddy is last of them all. Moving for the turn, Valid and Ender's Cat. These two are stride for stride, the heavy favorite on the outside, and the longest shot in the race down toward the rail. These two now clear from Savoy Stomp. Toward the inside, Team Colors follows in fourth. He's in front is next, and Rich Daddy will sit at the back of the field, 7 off the lead after an easy opening quarter mile in 24-2. Valid now taking charge a half length over Ender's Cat. Savoy Stomp creeping a bit closer now and up into second. Ender's Cat back to third. Then it's Team Colors fourth on the outside. Just about 2 lengths off the lead and 2 in front of He's in Front, who's fifth. And then it's Rich Daddy continuing to race about 8 lengths off the lead up the back stretch. Valid in front through a 48 1/2 mile. Valid by a length. Ender's Cat on the inside, Savoy Stomp, and right behind them is Team Colors, who's just a length and a half off the lead, racing past the half-mile pole. Then comes He's in Front and Rich Daddy. Into the turn, Valid on top, 3/4 of a length. Savoy Stomp on the outside. Team Colors just in behind horses needs a place to go. Ender's Cat starts to retreat along the rail. And then comes He's in Front and Rich Daddy. 3/4 up in 1/12 and 2. Coming toward the top of the stretch. And Valid will turn for home on the lead. Team Colors with a clear shot at Valid as they turn for home. Nick Juarez and Valid coming down to the eighth pole, trying to fend off the challenge of John Velasquez and Team Colors, who are a length and a half behind. Valid down to the 16th pole in front. Team Colors doing his best, but Valid's better, and Valid takes the skip away. And then it was Team Colors. Ender's Cat ends up third, and then Savoy Stomp.
Valid goes to the front as the 2-5 favorite, wins by a length and 3/4. The offspring of Medallia d'Oro returns $2.80. Team Colors finishes second, and by far the longest shot on the board at 66-1. Ender's Cat finishes third in the skip away. Continuing on over a sloppy sealed racetrack, time for 3-year-old fillies in what used to be the old Bonnie Miss, the Gulfstream Park Oaks.
They're off in the Gulfstream Park Oaks. Paula Queen on the inside, sent to the front by Javier Castellano. And Hold On Mama, Longshot's got speed on the outside. Between those two, Go Maggie Go is up close to the pace. Off the tracks will sit behind them and run fourth outside of Double Entendre, who's down at the rail. And then it's back to Mo Green, and the trailer is Gomo. So they make their way to the back stretch. Paula Queen, the leader, by a length over Go Maggie Go and Hold On Mama as they complete the first quarter mile in 23 seconds flat. A solid opening fraction there. The heavy favorite off the tracks and John Velasquez are in fourth, and they're 3 lengths off the lead racing outside of Double Entendre. And then it's Mo Green. Gomo trails up the back stretch, and Gomo's 7 lengths off of Paula Queen, who continues to lead the way with 5 furlongs to go. Paula Queen on top. On top a length and a half here to Go Maggie Go, running in second position up the back stretch. The half is up in 46 3/5 seconds. These two are right together on the lead, and Hold On Mama is just to the outside of them in third. Off the tracks follows in fourth, moving around the far turn and now being ridden for more speed. John Velasquez asking off the track. She's starting to make a run though on the far outside. Gomo is just in behind horses with 3 lengths to make up, and off the tracks has hit the front as they come toward the top of the stretch. Go Maggie Go trying to stick with her and she's doing it as they come at the top of the lane here. Paola Queen follows in third and cuts the corner. Gomo's got work to do. They're into the stretch. And Go Maggie Go is holding on to this lead from off the tracks. Paola Queen is down on the inside. Go Maggie Go's got it close to home. It is Go Maggie Go. Paola Queen and off the tracks. Go Maggie Go wins the Gulfstream Park Oaks. Paola Queen was second. Off the tracks was third. And Gomo finished fourth.
Second time starter, ladies and gentlemen. My, how the game has changed. Go, Maggie, go. The offspring of Go Zapper sent out by Dale Romans. Ridden to victory by Luis Saez. They return $10 even. Polo Queen finishes second. And the 4-5 favorite, winner last year, the Skylerville, off the tracks in the Todd Pletcher barn now, finishes third in the Gulfstream Park Oaks. Over to the turf, where the turf course was listed as good, the Appleton.
They're off in the Appleton. All included on the inside goes out of the gate well. Long on value's got speed to force the pass from the outside. And further out, it's Reporting Star. Then Sky Captain with Exultation, Divisi Darrow to the outside, and Actabante will trail the field early as they race for the turn with Long on Value in front. Long on Value on top a length and a half, force the pass, close up to the pace, running in second, with Reporting Star third to the outside and All Included riding the rail, three lengths off the lead onto the backstretch after a 23-4 opening quarter mile. Then Sky Captain racing on the outside of With Exultation. Divisi Darrow is going up on the outside of those two, and the trailer is Actabante, who's seven lengths off the lead. Long on Value up the backstretch in front. Force the pass, continues to press the pace in second with Reporting Star third to the outside. The three of them are tightly packed and now force the pass to the front after a 47-3 half mile. Force the pass, a neck in front of Long on Value. Reporting Star third to the outside. Divisi Darrow in the midst of his run now, and here he goes on the far outside. Sky Captain is next. All Included is down on the inside, being ridden along to go. With Exultation is next, and they're coming to the top of the stretch, and it's forced the pass and Divisi Darrow on the outside. Between those two, Reporting Star is third, then Long on Value. Force the pass coming down to the final 16th. On the outside, Reporting Star, Divisi Darrow down the center of the course. Here's Reporting Star, and Reporting Star wins the Appleton. And then it was Divisi Darrow in a photo with Force the Pass, followed by Sky Captain and Long on Value.
Reporting Star scores the victory for Luis Saez. They return $19 even for the upset victory. Divisi Darrow finishes second, and the 5-2 favorite, Force the Pass, finishes third in this year's Appleton. Staying on the turf, though, Turf Marathon used to be at 12 furlongs. The 11 furlong fillies and mares in the Orchid.
They're off in the Orchid. Crizole on the inside breaks well, and now being joined and passed by Quiet Kitten on the outside, who goes up to grab the lead. Quiet Kitten to the front. Photo Call has moved up into second position early on. And then it's My Sweet Girl third to the outside. Suffused is next. And then Pretty and Sweet and Crizole down toward the rail. Three lengths off the lead into a slower lead pace. Then Song of Ice and Fire. Maximova is only about 4.5 lengths behind early on. Aknaha trails to an opening quarter mile of 25-1. So we're into the stretch for the first time, and Javier Castellano takes the initiative here with the favorite Photo Call, and they're going to kick on with it and lead the way by two. Quiet Kitten will sit second over My Sweet Girl, and then it's Crizole on the inside of Suffused with a lap to run. Pretty and Sweet is next, and then Maximova, Song of Ice and Fire, and about seven lengths more back to Aknaha, who trails through a 49-4 half mile. So they go into the next turn here in pursuit of Photo Call, who leads Quiet Kitten by a length and three quarters. And then it's Pretty and Sweet on the outside running in third. Crizole is fourth. Suffused follows fifth with five lengths to make up as they enter the backstretch. And then Longshot Pretty and Sweet racing on the outside of Maximova. And they're tracked by Song of Ice and Fire, who's well clear of Aknaha. Three quarters up in 1:15 flat. Up the backstretch. Photo Call out there by a length and three quarters. Quiet Kitten continues to track in second. Then Pretty and Sweet third on the outside. Suffused is down toward the rail. And right there in between horses, My Sweet Girl is there. A length and a half farther back to Song of Ice and Fire. Then Maximova, Crizole not keeping up, and Aknaha at the back. Around the far turn, still Photo Call. Photo Call rambling along on the lead here by a length and a half. My Sweet Girl on the outside. Down toward the inside is Suffused. And Suffused is going to be angled off the rail by Jose Lescano to try to come and get this front runner into the final furlong. Photo Call by 2.5. Suffused is into second and Maximov is third on the inside. Photo Call drifting out through the stretch but still clear. Late run from Song of Ice and Fire, who's charging through on the inside. But Photo Call holds on. Song of Ice and Fire was second, and then came Aknaha, Maximova, and Suffused.
Photo Call with Javier Castellano and the Irons, the offspring of Galileo, trained by Todd Pletcher, the even money favorite, up front, then set the pace, scores by 3/4 of a length, returning $4 even. Song of Ice and Fire finished second, and at 23-1, Aknaha, who was well back early, finishes third. Back to the dirt now by race number 10. The dirt had been upgraded to good, the Sir Shackleton.
They're off in the Sir Shackleton. Grand Shores bounced out of the gate quickly. Defer Heaven is now showing speed on the outside. WB Jet Center is next. On the inside is Brothers of the Time. Then Just Call Kenny. And Squadron A is well behind early as they head up the backstretch. Defer Heaven in front by a neck. On the outside, WV Jet Center is running in second position. These two take them halfway up the backstretch in front of Grand Shores in third. The first quarter is up in 22 3/5 seconds. Just Call Kenny is fourth, racing 5 lengths off the lead past the half-mile pole. Then Brothers of the Time and Squadron A. So they move for the turn and Defer Heaven, tested all along here by WV Jet Center. These two noses apart on the lead with 3 furlongs to go. And right behind them is Grand Shores running in third. Just Call Kenny on the outside, fourth. Squadron A and Brothers of the Time at the back of the pack, and the rails open for Grand Shores, and Edgar Zayas sends him on through after a 44 4/2 mile, and Grand Shores has stormed to the front at the top of the stretch. And Squadron A is getting going now, taking second from Defer Heaven at the eighth pole. Grand Shores by 4. Squadron A into second, then comes Defer Heaven, Brothers of the Time, and Just Call Kenny. It's Grand Shores. Grand Shores takes the Sir Shackleton over Squadron A. And then came Brothers of the Time, or Just Call Kenny, followed by Defer Heaven.
Grande Shores, no XY Jet in here, scores impressively by a length and 3/4 for Edgar Zayas. Returns $9.40. Squadron A finishes second. Brothers of the Time finishes third. The 6-5 favorite, Defer Heaven, beats one horse while finishing fifth in the Sir Shackleton. Back to the turf over a good listed turf course, the Honey Fox.
They're off in the Honey Fox. Mississippi Delta and Celestine both had good beginnings. Sandiva came out running in third, and then its elusive collection is Temmie the Torpedo, is guided to the inside to save ground going into the turn. Lady Lara is second last early on, a little bit sassy, trails the field 8 lengths off of front-running Celestine. So Junior Alvarado and Celestine make the pace here, and Mississippi Delta is a length and a half behind. Sandiva tracks them with Elusive Collection in fourth as they enter the back stretch. 2 lengths more back to Temmie the Torpedo. Lady Lara moves up alongside of her, just 4.5 lengths off the lead, and the trailer is a little bit sassy. They went 24-2 for the first quarter mile. Celestine makes the pace. Mississippi Delta her company. Second on the outside, Sandiva follows in third. Elusive Collection is fourth. Then Temmie the Torpedo. Lady Lara to the outside. Out of traffic in harm's way. 4.5 lengths off the lead. And the trailer is a little bit sassy at the rear of the field, a 48 2/2 mile. For Celestine and Mississippi Delta, who are a neck apart moving for the far turn. Elusive Collection continues to track them while Sandiva saves ground and Lady Lara moves 3 wide. She comes now on the far outside. Temmie the Torpedo is next, and a little bit sassy trails the field as Celestine takes him to the top of the stretch. 3/4 1/12 4. Celestine off the turn in front. Mississippi Delta runs at her on the outside. Celestine a length. Mississippi Delta tries to stick with her, but Celestine kicks away by 2. Celestine by 3. Mississippi Delta, Sandiva, and Elusive Collection far behind Celestine, who wires them into Honey Fox. Mississippi Delta was next, then Sandiva, a photo with Elusive Collection, and Temmie the Torpedo fifth.
Celestine goes to the front for Junior Alvarado and Bill Mott. They have been on a roll, especially Bill Mott, the last 10 or 12 days. Celestine scores the victory, returning $12.60. Mississippi Delta, second longest shot on the board at 12-1, does finish second. Sandiva finishes third. The 2-1 favorite, Lady Lara, finishes a disappointing sixth. Staying on the turf, the 12 furlong Pan American.
They're off in the Pan American. Seeking Alpha, Jay Gatsby, O Prado Ole, and there goes Gran Tito now. Up in between horses to be close up to the pace. Kaigun is down toward the inside. Zavarian is right there in mid-pack as well. And going up on the outside is Hello Don Julio now by rivals up the backstretch. So they make their way for that first turn, and it is Seeking Alpha in front. O Prado Ole is second on the outside. And they're followed by Hello Don Julio in third. Gran Tito is fourth. Zavarian is next on the outside of Jay Gatsby, who's racing 4.5 lengths off the lead after a sharp opening quarter mile for the distance of 23 4/5 seconds. Then St. Albans boy Kaigan has been shuffled to the rear of the field just ahead of Wake Forest. So they're into the stretch for the first time. And it is Seeking Alpha, the leader. On the inside is the big favorite, Gran Tito's in tight there, down toward the rail. O Prado Ole is alongside. Then Hello Don Julio, the half is up in 48 3/5 seconds. Zavarian is next, Jay Gatsby on the inside. Then St. Albans boy, Kaigan. And Wake Forest is still about 8 lengths off the lead. Seeking Alpha on top in the race to the next turn. Prompted along by O Prado Ole, and to the outside of them, it's Hello Don Julio. These three take them into the turn, 1, 2, 3, and now slipping through on the inside is Gran Tito. They've been followed by Jay Gatsby and Zavarian, and right behind them is St. Albans boy and Kaigan, and then Wake Forest at the back, 3/4 up in 1, 14 1. On to the backstretch. Seeking Alpha, Luis Saez, a length and a half in front. With Gran Tito running in second now and just to the outside of the leader, cutting the gap to 3/4 of a length. Then Jay Gatsby to the inside. Hello Don Julio. Zavarian is right there between those two. A length and a half to St. Albans boy. And then it's Kaigan, Wake Forest, and O Prado Ole. They make their way for the far turn, and they are in pursuit of Seeking Alpha, who continues to lead the way. And Gran Tito gets closer. Now these two are side by side up front. Hello Don Julio next. Jay Gatsby just one off the rail. Zavarian's in between horses. Then St. Albans boy and Kaigan. Wake Forest in behind them. It is wide open at the top of the stretch. Gran Tito takes the lead. It's Gran Tito in front. Jay Gatsby, Zavarian up the rail. Wake Forest is closing in. Kaigan is there on the far outside. And here comes Kaigan. Now, Kaigan and Wake Forest, and they've gone by Gran Tito late. Wake Forest and Kaigan, these two come down to the wire. Wake Forest and Kaigan. Kaigan did it today. Beats Wake Forest in the Pan American. And then a photo between Gran Tito and St. Albans boy.
The three horses they bet in inverted order are right there on the board. Kaigan, the third choice in the wagering, scores the victory, turning $7.60. Wake Forest, second choice in the wagering, finishes second. And the 9-5 favorite, Gran Tito, finishes third. And now we're up to the showdown, East versus West, undefeated versus undefeated, the Grade 1 Florida Derby.
They're off in the Florida Derby. And Nyquist had a beautiful start. Chovanes is away with speed on the outside. Sawyer's Mickey came out running in third, and Mohaman is right there, but caught wide into that turn. Four deep for Mohaman into the first turn. And then a long shot coping away, who's in between horses. Majesto is down on the inside. Take it to the edge. We'll have to come off the pace here. Four lengths off the lead early on. A break of 2.5 to Isofast, who races to the outside of Fashionable Freddy, while Fellowship is last early. The first quarter was in 23 3/5 seconds, and Nyquist will lead the field onto the backstretch of the Florida Derby. Nyquist a half length in front of Chovanes. Sawyer's Mickey is next, and Mohaman is right there in fourth, outside of horses, two lengths off the lead, and not far behind at all up the backstretch. And then in between horses is Coping Away. Take it to the edge. Majesto on the inside. Fashionable Freddy right alongside of Fellowship. Isofast, last of them all, six lengths off the lead after a 47 flat half mile. So Nyquist is a half mile from home in the Florida Derby and leads it by a neck. Sawyer's Mickey on the inside. There goes Mohamen now. Mohamen is moving on the outside of horses. Coping Away is in fourth, and then comes Majesto. Around the far turn, and here's the battle. It is Nyquist in front, and Mohamen has moved up into second on the outside. And the two of them will come toward the top of the stretch together. Three quarters in one, 11 and one. And they're into the stretch, and it's Nyquist and Mohamen in their bi-coastal battle at the top of the stretch. On the inside is Majesto in third. Nyquist has moved away. Mohamen has no answer today. On the inside is Majesto, and then comes Fellowship. Nyquist drifting out to the center of the track, but he's far in front, and Nyquist is still unbeaten. He has won the Florida Derby. Majesto was second. Fellowship was third. Mohamen settles for fourth, and Sawyer's Mickey was fifth in a final time of 1 minute 49.11 seconds.
Well, a little drifting in the lane, but Nyquist went to the front, ladies and gentlemen, over the good dirt course, the offspring of Uncle Mo. Boy, never looked like he had an anxious moment. Drew off to win by 3+ lengths as the 6-5 second choice for Doug O'Neill. They get the $1 million bonus. They get the $589,000 winner's share. So a tremendous day for the Redham stable. Mario Gutierrez, Doug O'Neill, Nyquist returns $4.40. The offspring of Uncle Mo remains undefeated as the champ. Majesto finishes second. Fellowship finishes third. Both of them off the pace at a big price. And Mohamen, the 4-5 favorite, finishes fourth. His chances may have been severely compromised on the post position draw. Wide, wide, and wide, tried to make one move, but was no match for Nyquist. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, the big Saturday afternoon at Turfway Park.
No matter where in the world you are, the excitement of wagering on horse racing is just a click away. CapitalOTB.com offers live streaming, past performances, race replays, our virtual tote board, analysis and selections from professional handicappers, and a simple, safe, and secure wagering platform. And best of all, you get track prices. Going on now, it's Bet 50, Get 50. Simply open a Capital Bets account, bet $50, and get $50 cash back. CapitalOTB.com. Log on today.
There's nothing like the thrill and excitement of horse racing. And now, the new home for all the best racing and all the top tracks is OTB-TV, Digital Channel 8.2. Delivering each day the best racing across the country and around the world. Whether it's Saratoga or Belmont here in New York, Florida's Gulfstream Park, or California's Del Mar and Santa Anita racecourses, no other network brings you the grandeur of horse racing like OTB-TV on Digital Channel 8.2.
Funding your Capital OTB bet account is as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1, easy money. Clearly the fastest and easiest method of depositing funds into your account. Make deposits or withdrawals in just minutes. 2, Green Dot Money Pack. Gives you instant access to your funds. Green Dot Money Packs are available at thousands of retailers nationwide. And 3, MasterCard Visa. Simply click on the link from the funding page, enter your account information, and fund your account. CapitalOTBBet.com. Log on today.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning our attention to a sunny Saturday afternoon over at Turfway Park. Up first, the Rushaway.
And they're off. Fast start from between horses for the long shot Alte Rita. Through from the inside, there goes back together again. The West Point Thoroughbred Scholar Athlete came away racing in the third position. Up to the outside, Hill Pay racing away in fourth. And between those two comes a Virtual Machine. Then a length further back is Keystone for Victory, one in front of Alte Rita. Then a separation of about three, Rated R Superstar has worked his way all the way over to the rail and is flanked by Triple Creek. As the field straightens up for the backstretch run, the first quarter a fast 23 seconds flat. And back together again, leads him for the backstretch run, in front by two, setting that fast pace. Gimlet tracking in the pocket spot while racing on the inside. The long shot Bandar presses that one to the outside. Then a length further back through from between horses comes a Scholar Athlete, and Hill Pay is knifing up his way in between rivals. Down along the inside comes Rated R Superstar, still out wide, Triple Creek. Then a length to the two trailers is Alte Rita at the back of the Keystone Victory as they make their entrance into the turn. The first half, 47 1/5 seconds, and that's all for Back Together Again. Here comes Gimlet through from the inside, attacked to the outside by Virtual Machine. The rails open for Hill Pay, and Mitchell Murrow's going to try to send that one on through, and they stack up three across the track outside the quarter pole. Running on from the back, here comes Rated R Superstar, White Blinkers, Yellow Cap's going to tip to the outside, and also Scholar Athletes riding the rails. They straight for the stretch drive. It's Hill Pay who turns first. Hill Pay off the turn with two to spare. Virtual Machine attacks to the outside, down the center of the track, still making good headway as Rated R Superstar by the 16th pole. Hill Pay opening up in deep stretch. Virtual Machine still running at him, but down toward the line. Here's win number 1,000 for Larry Jones as Hill Pay takes the Rush Away Stakes. Virtual Machine was second, long way back to Rated R Superstar, and Gimlet was fourth in 1:44.1.
Hill Pay certainly does to his backers. Larry Jones sends out the winner, Mitchell Merrill, in the saddle at nearly 13-1. The offspring of Haynesville returns $27.60. Virtual Machine finishes second. Rated R Superstar, third choice, finishes third. And the 7-5 favorite, Gimlet, checks in fourth. Now time for the three-year-old fillies in the Bourbonette Oaks.
They are off in the 34th running of the Bourbonette Oaks. And it's Wondermint who's sending on out to take early supremacy. Marquis Mist displaying good pace right to that one's outside as well. Spun out about three deep comes American Doll as they race into the clubhouse turn. Miss Media had to take off her heels there in fourth. Through from the inside comes Lemon Drop Bell. Then a link further back to Artesian, just to the outside of Red Fern Doll, who hugs that rail spot. Castile's Angel is about six lengths off the pace. Then a link further back to Egyptian Honey is two in front of Doro Danza. Then a link to Lookout Sister, and outpaced at the back of the pack. Inconclusive is last, and about 15 lengths off the pace setter. The first quarter mile was 23 1/5 seconds. They make their way up the back stretch. They have 4.5 furlongs still to travel. So it's Wonderman has shouldered the load thus far, in front by a half a side. Marquis Miss there in second. Through from the inside, Miss Meteor is third. Still parked out wide comes American Doll in the fourth position. Artesian is a close-up fifth. Also closing in now comes Egyptian Honey. Castile's Angel being ridden with a whip to keep pace. Now that one's being passed by Lookout Angel and starting to unwind from the back of the pack. Inconclusive has went from last up into mid-pack as they're midpoint through the turn. The first half, 47 seconds. And it's Wonderment who's led him throughout. Still pressed to the outside, Marquis Miss. Through from the inside comes Moonlit Meteor to the outside. American Doll and still continue to make good headway. Inconclusive as they straighten for the stretch drive. But nobody's yet to get to Wonderment. Marquis Miss lugging in badly back in second. Still running on from the back. American Doll, deep stretch here. Wonderment has turned back all challengers. Wonderment goes by the 16th pole with three to the good. Inconclusive is running on for the minor awards, but it's all over up front. Wonderment in a wire-to-wire score to take the Bourbonette Oaks in front by about four in the end. Running time, 1:39 flat.
Wonderment goes to the front four. Kenrick Peak sends out this runner for his wife. Cornelio Velasquez in the saddle. Makes every call. Wins by 3 3/4 as the co-second choice in the wagering. Wonderment returns $10 even. Inclusive finishes second. Marquis Miss, the 3-1 favorite, finishes third. And now annually the big day, the big race, I should say, at Turfway Park. Under many, many different names this year, the Horseshoe Casino Cincinnati Spiral.
And they're off in the 45th running of the Spiral Stakes. And wasting no time, outside Azar will get the first call. Rayless is displaying early speed as well. Right to those two's inside is the Aerial Force displaying pace presence as well in third. Two-step time came away racing in the fourth position. Tugging hard against 4 Ounce Drew is Jensen down along the rail in fifth. Out to the outside, stablemates Oscar nominated and Strike Up the Band. Those two come next. They're a length in front of Don't Be So Salty. Surgical Strike, the Battaglia winner, hugs the rail. Out wide comes Stragger Jagger. In between horses comes Cassiopeia. And a long way last, lethargically at the back of the pack. That makes sense. Must be about 19 lengths as they pass the 6 furlong marker. And they straighten up on the backstretch. The first quarter mile was quick, 23-1. To the inside, it's Rayless. To the outside, Azar really tugging hard on Manny Franco there. Racing up into the center of the track. Here comes Jensen, who is in third. Down along the inside, keen to go on is Aerial Force in fourth. Two steps time is fifth. Then a link back to Oscar nominated through from the inside, Don't Be So Salty. Up to that one's outside is Strike Up the Band, races about eighth, about nine off the pace. Cassiopeia trying to knife his way between horses, moving wide comes Swagger Jagger, and the late running Battaglia winner, Surgical Strike, is starting to make his move as they make their entrance into the turn. Half mile, 48-1, and on the inside, it's Rayless. To the outside, Azar, these two nip and tuck. To the outside, there's Jensen. Into center of the track, here comes Oscar-nominated Cassiopeia, finally found that seam, and Surgical Strike starting to run on from the back as they reach the top of the lane. And it's Rayless been there every step of the way. Azara attacks to the outside. Here's Oscar nominated coming down the center of the track. Jensen had to take up. And Surgical Strike has kicked it into top gear. And down the stretch they roll. It's Surgical Strike to the outside. Oscar nominated still there. Azara fighting on down to the wire. Oscar nominated puts the nose in front. And Oscar nominated takes the Spiral Stakes by a nose in 151 flat.
And no matter what name you call it, the 19th consecutive losing favorite, ladies and gentlemen, you have to go all the way back to event of the year in 1998. And heck, that race was delayed a day for electrical outage. But Oscar nominated in a five-horse photo finish. Yes, the offspring of Kitten's Joy, Mike Maker, Ken Ramsey, Brian Hernandez Jr., they light up the tote board. $49.20. Azar finishes second. Surgical Strike finishes third. Aeroforce, the 2-1 favorite, finishes eighth. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, a pair of stakes races from Santa Anita.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week, OTB TV is the Capital Region's choice for the most comprehensive and informative coverage of thoroughbred and harness racing. OTB TV is the only area network delivering a steady viewership, reaching more than 540,000 households throughout the broadcast day and into the evening. Capital OTB's digital presence also plays a tremendous part in getting your message in front of potential customers. With more and more wagering moving to online, CapitalOTB.com can put your message in front of thousands of potential customers 24 hours a day. And with the addition of our new mobile app, new customers will see your message on all their digital devices. To see how affordably you can reach thousands of new customers, contact Capital OTB's sales and marketing department today.
Funding your Capital OTB bet account is as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1, easy money. Clearly the fastest and easiest method of depositing funds into your account. Make deposits or withdrawals in just minutes. 2, Green Dot Money Pack. Gives you instant access to your funds. Green Dot Money Packs are available at thousands of retailers nationwide. And 3, MasterCard Visa. Simply click on the link from the funding page, enter your account information, and fund your account. CapitalOTBBet.com. Log on today.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turn our attention to Saturday afternoon down the hill at Santa Anita in the San Simeon.
Racing. Producer Off Awkwardly is a clear last to get going. Mr. Sexy through towards the inside, speeds to the lead as expected. Guns Loaded's moving up second as most anticipated. Then comes No Silent outside Nashville, Il Fornaio outside of Hey Dude and Cape Wolf, followed by Aotearoa and Producer. At the half mile pole, 8 lengths covering the field, and Mr. Sexy being joined by the favourite Guns Loaded, No Silent 3/4 of a length back third on the inside, followed after 1.5 by outside Nashville, 2 lengths to Cape Wolf and company with Hey Dude as they come past the 3/8, and then a gap of another 3 lengths, Il Fornaio. Three further back is Producer joining Aotearoa. Thundering down to the court of pole in the San Simeon Stakes. Guns Loaded, Mr. Sexy are the two leaders. Bejarano with a good grip on the favourite. Outside Nashville just wandering a little bit wide over the dirt crossing. No Silent to his inside. Next is Cape Wolf as they come past the eighth pole. Hey Dude at the head of the others. Guns Loaded's the leader moving past Mr. Sexy. 2 lengths clear then of No Silent. Followed by Cape Wolf threading between horses. Hey Dude at the head of the others, but Guns Loaded is the leader. A length and a half, Cape Wolf is running on strongly, but Guns Loaded makes it 3 wins in a row, beating Cape Wolf by a length. No Silent was third. Hey Dude ran fourth.
Guns loaded, the 8-5 favorite for Doug O'Neill, Rafael Bejarano. They score the victory, returning $5.40. Cape Wolf finishes second. No Silent finishes third. And this week we had one Sunday stakes race to bring you. It was out at San Anita, 12 furlongs on the dirt, the Tokyo City Cup.
Racing. Ike Walker gets the best of the start from Lieutenant Colonel, who's moving up to him smartly. Then John's Success, class leader, easing back along the rail, joined by China Girl Lover and Blingo. And Big John B drifts back six lengths last. Around the far turn for the first time, John's Success takes the lead by a half length. Ike Walker and Lieutenant Colonel out wider. Pace looks pretty true at the mile and a quarter mark. China Girl Lover and Blingo sharing fourth position, clear of class leader and a good long gap to Big John B. Homeward bound on the first occasion, John's Success in front, the pace steadying now. Lieutenant Colonel under heavy restraint on the outside, and Ike Walker is along the rail, followed by China Girl Lover and Blingo together. Class leader is back five lengths off second last, three clear of Big John B. John's Success greets the judges with a circuit to go in the Tokyo City Cup, leading Lieutenant Colonel half a length, followed by Ike Walker, Blingo and China Girl Lover with five lengths to class leader and two lengths to Big John B. With 7/8 left to go, John's Success, the long shot stablemate to the favourite, has the lead over Lieutenant Colonel, Ike Walker, Blingo and China Girl Lover, four lengths to class leader and three lengths to Big John B. Less than 3/4 of a mile to go. They've made halfway, and it's John's Success by 3/4. Lieutenant Colonel, the least experienced runner in the field, in second position. Two lengths, Ike Walker running a third. Blingo is fourth, and China Girl Lover fifth. Class leader has 10 lengths to pick up and is followed by Big John B in the run to the half mile, where it's John's Success over Lieutenant Colonel. 2.5 lengths to Ike Walker. Blingo outside China Girl Lover from class leader, and Big John B, the inside, has 10 lengths to pick up. John's Success in front of Lieutenant Colonel, 3/8 to go. Three lengths to Ike Walker, China Girl Lover, Blingo, class leader out three wide. Big John B is last, he's edging off the rail at this point, trying to thread his way through a pack of horses in front of him. John's Success joined by Lieutenant Colonel. Bejarano's in some bother here on Big John B. He's now getting through. He was held up, though, around the turn a little bit. He's getting to the outside fourth, and class leader has come up fast on the outside to tackle the leaders. It's class leader joining Lieutenant Colonel, and here comes Big John B barreling down the outside. It's Big John B engaging class leader with a 16th left to go in the Tokyo City Cup, and Big John B is starting to rush away. He'll win it well. 2.5 lengths to class leader. Blingo grabbed first from Lieutenant Colonel.
Big John B, the 3-2 favorite for good guy Phil D'Amato. Rafael Bejarano makes it 2 over the weekend from last to first, winning by 2.25. The offspring of Hardspun returns $5 even as the favorite. Class leader finishes second. Blingo finishes third in this year's Tokyo City Cup. We take our final break. When we come back, big Saturday afternoon at the Big A.
Now get all the racing information you need right on your mobile device with Capital OTB's new mobile app. Wager anytime, anywhere, right from your smartphone or tablet. Get up-to-the-minute scratches and race results. Watch our morning TV shows. Check out the Handicapper's Report. Find a branch or EasyBet location and be up-to-date on all our latest promotions. It's everything you need to watch, wager, and win right at your fingertips. The new Capital OTB mobile app. Download it free from the iTunes Store or Google Play.
There's nothing like the thrill and excitement of horse racing. And now, the new home for all the best racing and all the top tracks is OTB-TV on Time Warner Cable Channel 1250, delivering each day the best racing across the country and around the world. Whether it's Saratoga or Belmont here in New York, Florida's Gulfstream Park, or California's Del Mar and Santa Anita race courses, no other network brings you the grandeur of horse racing like OTB-TV on Time Warner Cable Channel 1250.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning our attention to the Big A, unfortunately, the rains came and we had a muddy racetrack on Saturday afternoon. Sunday's race card ended up being canceled because of the winds, but we have six from Saturday. Up first, the Hall of Famer, Extra Heat.
And they're off. One horse refused at the start. That would be number 3, Stormy Sky. Stormy Sky refused at the start. From the outside, it's Enduring Touch. At the rail, Sweet Ray of Sunshine. Then it's Northern Screamer, who's racing in third, and Distinctive Lady is fourth. Enduring Touch has the lead as the field goes around the far turn. The quarter one in 22 and three. Enduring Touch by a length. Sweet Ray of Sunshine, the gray, is second by a head. Northern Screamer's on the outside in third. And Distinctive Lady is fourth. Here comes Sweet Ray of Sunshine up the inside to challenge Enduring Touch and now to take the lead. Sweet Ray of Sunshine's in front. Northern Screamer up on the outside into second. Then it's Enduring Touch and Distinctive Lady. Sweet Ray of Sunshine has the lead with Northern Screamer giving chase in second as they pass the eighth pole. Sweet Ray of Sunshine is clear by two. Then Northern Screamer, Distinctive Lady, and Enduring Touch. They come on for the finish, and it will be Sweet Ray of Sunshine who wins by more than three at the end. Northern Screamer was second, and Distinctive Lady finished third.
David Jacobson owns, trains the winner. The Ortiz brothers win 7 of the 10 on Saturday, including the extra heat. Sweet Ray of Sunshine, the 4-5 favorite, makes it look easy. Wins by 3 3/4 over the muddy sealed racetrack, returning $3.60. Northern Screamer finishes second. Distinctive Lady finishes third. At the end of the day, Stormy Sky was declared a non-starter in the extra heat. Continuing it on, sprinting at the Big A, the Peeping Tom.
And they're off. The Big Deluxe, Dad's Laugh at the rail. Drax Hall Woods in between horses up the backstretch. It's Dad's Laugh with a head in front of the Big Deluxe. Drax Hall Woods runs in third. Matoris is down at the rail in fourth. And Jeter is the trailer. Up front, Dad's Laugh and the Big Deluxe. And they are heads apart for the lead heading into the far turn. The opening quarter, 22 1/5 seconds. Dad's Laugh at the rail leads by a half length. The Big Deluxe on the outside is second by two. Then it's Matoris, Drax Hall Woods, and Jeter remains at the back. Dad's Laugh gets clear now by almost a length over the Big Deluxe. Matoris down on the inside. Drax Hall Woods is fourth. And Jeter, and now they're at the top of the stretch. And it is Dad's Laugh with the lead after a half. 45 4/5 seconds in the mud. Dad's Laugh is the leader. Matoris at the rail. In between horses there is the Big Deluxe. On the outside, Drax Hall Woods and Jeter. Dad's Laugh with a three-length lead as they come down for the finish. Then it's Drax Hall Woods and Jeter. Dad's Laugh with a front-running score. And Jose Ortiz has three wins already.
Bruce Levine, Rapoli Stables, Jose Ortiz. So they score the victory with Dad's Laugh. They win by a comfortable 2 1/4 lengths from the inside. The second choice in the wagering makes it look easy, returning $5.70. Jeter finishes second, and the 7-5 favorite, Draxel Woods, finishes third. Now time to go 9 furlongs on the dirt, the Mr. Sinatra.
And the rough. Royal Posse and Little Jerry. Little Jerry hustled out there trying to get that early lead going into the clubhouse turn, and Little Jerry has the lead. And then it's Royal Posse on the outside. It's Indycott, Don't Bet with Bruno, runs in fourth, and Jaeger is the early trailer in fifth. Now Little Jerry steps away here to lead by 3.5, almost 4 lengths. Indycott runs in second, and then it's Royal Posse next in third, and now the field has reached the back stretch. The opening quarter mile was running 23 3/5 seconds. Little Jerry by 4. Indycott in second. Don't Bet with Bruno. Royal Posse right together third and fourth, and Jaeger continues the trail as the field races midway up the back stretch. Little Jerry continues to show the way. Little Jerry by 4 lengths. Indycott giving chase in second after a half and 47 4. Don't Bet with Bruno on the outside and Royal Posse down at the rail. And then it's Jaeger in fifth, and now there's a half mile to the wire. And Little Jerry, who's been in front right from the start, continues to lead, but now the lead's down to 2.5 lengths. Indycott getting a bit closer. So too is Royal Posse, who's advancing down at the rail. Then it's Don't Bet with Bruno and Jaeger midway on the turn. Here comes Royal Posse to the inside of Little Jerry. Royal Posse now takes the lead from Little Jerry. Endicott's on the outside in third, then Don't Bet with Bruno and Jaeger. And the field comes into the stretch with Royal Posse, the leader by length. Endicott driving up on the outside. Little Jerry is dropped back. Then Don't Bet with Bruno and Jaeger. Royal Posse in front and less than an eighth of a mile to the finish. Royal Posse by two. Then Endicott and Don't Bet with Bruno on the outside. It's Royal Posse by three, and Royal Posse will win at the end by a little more than three lengths. It was very close for second between Endicott and Don't Bet with Bruno.
Royal Posse, yes, the offspring of Posse going out for Rudy Rodriguez, who's been on a tremendous roll as the main track opened up on Thursday at the Big A. The even money favorite with Irad Ortiz Jr. in the saddle scores by 3 3/4, returning $4 even. Endicott finishes second. Don't Bet with Bruno, the 2-1 second choice, finishes third in the Mr. Sinatra. Now racing the dirt one turn mile, the Stud Muffin.
And they're off. Number one, Second City, jumped up at the start, trails the field. Toledo Eddie is out for the lead and quickly opens up three lengths. African Fighter runs in second. Then it's Mills, North Slope, and after that awkward beginning, Second City. They cross over now from the chute to the main track. And it's Toledo Eddie in front by a little more than two. African Fighter runs in second. Second City has advanced into third, in between horses in North Slope, and Mills is on the outside. The quarter went in 24 seconds in the mud, and it is the big favorite, Toledo Eddie, with the lead here by two. African Fighter in second by a head. Then it's North Slope, Second City, and on the far outside, Mills. Toledo Eddie leads as they pass the half-mile pole. Ran the opening half in 47 and 2/5 seconds. It is Toledo Eddie with a length and a half lead. North Slope now up on the outside, second by a head, and Second City is down at the rail in third. Then Mills, and the trailer is African Fighter. Toledo Eddie in front as they come for the head of the stretch. North Slope is all out in second. And then it's Mills on the far outside. Three quarters went in 1:11 3. Toledo Eddie has a three-length lead. North Slope and Mills, then Second City and African Fighter. Toledo Eddie has been in front right from the start, continues to lead. Mills putting in one late run, but will not catch Toledo Eddie. Holy Toledo, Jose Ortiz wins another. Four victories on the day.
David Jacobson own trains. Jose Ortiz rides, goes to the front. Toledo Eddie, the 1-2 favorite, wins by 2 1/4, returning $3 even. Mills finishes second, and the only double-digit price horse in the race at 10-1, the long shot, North Slope, finishes third. Up next, the 7-furlong sprint named after one of the best claims of all time and probably one of the best claims for Todd Pletcher, the Kaja Electronica.
And they're off. Cerro Away Well, Bon Vigilante. On the far outside is Anubin Ridge. Then it's 83, and at the rail is Because I'm Happy. Change Will Do You Good is running in sixth. Life in Shambles in seventh. Gap of Three, Classic Salsa, the trailer in eighth. And the field moves up the muddy backstretch. And it's Bon Vigilante and Because I'm Happy. Heads apart for the lead with Cerro just off those front runners in third. Life in Shambles now comes on through to take fourth. 83 is alongside in fifth. Then it's Anubin Ridge. Change Will Do You Good. Farther back, Classic Salsa. The opening quarter mile, 22 and 4/5 seconds. And they start the run around the far turn. Bon Vigilante is the leader as Because I'm Happy drops back. Bon Vigilante, 3/4 of a length. Cerro on the outside in second. And then it's Because I'm Happy, Life in Shambles, 83, and Anubin Ridge. Farther back, Classic Salsa and Change Will Do You Good. The half mile in 45 and 2/5 seconds. Now they're in the stretch. Bon Vigilante and Cerro. Cerro now takes the lead. Anubin Ridge is moving up into second. Then 83, Bon Vigilante and Life in Shambles down at the rail. Cerro's in front with a 16th to the finish. And then Anubin Ridge in second. They come on down for the finish line, and it will be Cerro by 2.5 lengths. Anubin Ridge was second, and 83 finished third.
Sarah Oh, the 2-1 favorite for Danny Gargan and Kendrick Carmouche. They score by 2 3/4, returning $6 even. Newbin Ridge finishes second. 83 finishes third. And wrapping up the stakes action on Saturday afternoon over at the Big Eight, the Karakoram Electra.
And they're off. From the inside, it's Sun and Moon going for the lead. Then it is Nuff Said, Nuff Said. In between horses, Natalie Victoria. On the far outside, it's Brenda's Way. A gap of 2 lengths. Back to winning for Sarah and Champagne Ruby. And then it's another 4 to La Inesperada, who's the early trailer in 7th as they head up the backstretch. Sun and Moon down at the rail in front here by almost a length. Nuff Said in 2nd. And now Brenda's Way is coming through down on the inside. Natalie Victoria is racing in 4th. The quarter went in 22 seconds. Farther back at Champagne Ruby in 5th. And then winning for Sarah and La Inesperada. Midway on the turn, 3 of them across. Sun and Moon, Nuff Said, and Natalie Victoria. Champagne Ruby is on the move in 4th. That move is followed by La Inesperada, who takes 5th. Then it's winning for Sarah. And Brenda's Way has dropped out of it. The field comes off the turn and into the stretch. And Nuff Said has come away with the lead. Sun and Moon is back running in 2nd. Then it's Natalie Victoria down on the inside, winning for Sarah and La Inesperada. Nuff Said in front by a length and a half. Sun and Moon in 2nd. And here is 1 for the thumb. 5 wins today for Jose Ortiz. He wins the finale on Nuff Said, Nuff Said.
Danny Gargan does it again. Jose Ortiz does it again. Nuff Said, Nuff Said. Second choice in the wagering turns $8.70. Sun and Moon finishes 2nd in the 7-5 favorite. La Inesperada finishes 3rd in the Karakoram Electra. And on Sunday afternoon, as I mentioned earlier, the top flight was canceled with the racing, the whole card being canceled. We lost the top flight scheduled for Sunday afternoon. Well, that wraps up this week's edition of Agency, ladies and gentlemen. Hopefully the weather will improve from around the country, especially in the Capital District. Enjoy your stakes action and join us next time for Horses and Courses.
Watching OTB TV, a service of Capital Off-Track Betting.